Thank you. Evening, everyone. Welcome to our concert tonight. Thanks so much for joining us, to those of you who are here in Staples, and also to our friends and family members who are joining us on the live stream this evening. Thanks so much for spending your evening with us. I hope you enjoyed that first piece, Brant Carrick's Bayou Breakdown, which he wrote in dedication to his mentor, Frank Wicks, the director of bands at Louisiana State University. So Brant Carrick set out to write a four-voice fugue, and in homage to his mentor, Frank Wicks, at Louisiana State University, you may have noticed a little infusion of some Cajun flair along the way, and that was absolutely intentional. So it's been a lot of fun getting to work on this Cajun fugue over the last several months. We move now to Claude T. Smith's Fantasia for Alto Saxophone, which is going to feature our wonderful guest soloist, Dr. Andy Wen. Dr. Wen is the Associate Professor of Saxophone and Clarinet at University of Arkansas in Little Rock, and as you are about to hear, he is a really fantastic musician, a fantastic saxophone player. We're so thrilled to have had the opportunity to work with him on this piece and to get to perform it together with him tonight. You can see his, you can see the program for his bio, and as you'll see, Dr. Wen has performed all over the world in all kinds of different countries, and along the way has studied with some of the big names in saxophone. So he is truly a force to be reckoned with, and like I said, we are so happy to have had the opportunity to work with him. So at this time, would you please help me welcome Dr. Andy Wen to the stage.
Thank you.
Close our first half. We will now share with you a piece called Meridian by Ole Yalo. Ole Yalo is a Norwegian composer who has written for all kinds of different ensembles. One of his specialties actually is the choir. But in this piece for wind ensemble, we get to have a taste of Yalo's love for groove-oriented music. This piece features a rhythmic drive and energy that you're going to hear throughout the entire piece, and it's really fun to play, and I hope it's just as much fun for you to listen to as well. This piece actually includes an optional part for a choir, so since we don't have a choir with us tonight, I thought I might let you know a little bit about what the text says. The text basically describes a spiritual idea that our own individual energy pathways can unite into some kind of a spiritual whole. And the way that Yalo tries to get at this idea is through these repetitive groove-based patterns that kind of put you into a trance, almost. And that's the idea. That's what he's trying to get at in this piece, to kind of lull you into a trance-like state with the idea that we can all connect in that type of manner. The entire piece, as you'll hear, centers on the piano, which is Ole Yalo's own primary instrument, and we're thrilled to feature our very own Dr. John Krebs on this performance. Dr. Krebs is a professor of music here at Hendrix, a great friend of mine, a great colleague, a great mentor. He's been incredibly helpful to me over the last year and a half since I first started working here at Hendrix, so I'm really thrilled that we have an opportunity to collaborate with him. So even though you've already heard Dr. Krebs on the previous piece, and even though he's already sitting out on stage, would you please help me welcome and thank Dr. Krebs here for playing with us.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, and welcome back for our second half. I wanted to tell you a little bit about this piece here, which gives our program its name, Give Us This Day by David Maslenka. David Maslenka has to be one of my favorite composers, especially for the wind band. And it's because there's something about all of his music that just is so genuine and deeply meaningful. And in fact, on the few occasions that I've had the opportunity to meet Mr. Maslenka and talk with him a little bit, this is exactly what I found with him. His personality is very meaningful, very deep, very genuine. And I feel like it really comes out nicely in his music, in basically every piece I've ever heard by him. I think it's important to know a little bit about David Maslenka because it will tell you so much about why his music sounds the way it does. So Mr. Maslenka used to live a very fast-paced life in New York City, and at some point he decided that he wanted to change. So he started studying psychotherapy and psychology and eventually delved into dreams and meditation. And in fact, the way that he begins every single one of his days, particularly the days where he is composing, is with meditation. So there is something about this very introspective activity that he does every day that I think translates so very much into his music. So I thought perhaps the best thing I could do to help describe this incredible piece of music to you is to read his program note. So here it is. The words, "Give us this day," are of course from the Lord's Prayer, but the inspiration for this music is Buddhist. I have recently read a book by the Vietnamese Buddhist monk Thich Nhat Hanh entitled For a Future to Be Possible. His premise is that a future for the planet is only possible if individuals become deeply mindful of themselves, deeply connected to who they really are. While this is not a new idea and something that is an ongoing struggle for everyone, in my estimation, it is the issue for world peace. For me, writing music and working with people to perform music are two of those points of deep mindfulness. Music makes the connection to reality, and by reality, I mean a true awakeness and awareness. Give Us This Day gives us this very moment of awakeness and aware aliveness so that we can build a future in the face of a most dangerous and difficult time. I chose the subtitle Short Symphony for Wind Ensemble because the music isn't programmatic in nature. It has a full-blown symphonic character, even though there are only two movements. The music of the slower first movement is deeply searching, while that of the highly energized second movement is at times both joyful and sternly sober. The piece ends with a modal setting of the choral melody, Our Father in Heaven, which is number 110 from the 371 four-part chorales by Johann Sebastian Bach. So if I were to sum up his program note for you into a concise idea of what I think you'll hear, in the first movement, I believe we are seeing someone searching, meditating, being very introspective, trying to find out what his or her path is in life. And as the movement ends, it is as though this person has figured it out. There's the light bulb moment, and then the second movement is a mad rush to accomplish everything that this person believes is part of his or her mission in life. So I really hope you enjoy this incredible piece of music. This is David Maslenka's Give Us This Day. Thank you again so much for joining us this evening. We really appreciate your support here tonight, both here in Staples and to our friends and family on the live stream. So we have come now to the final piece, but before we play it for you, I just want to let you know that we are going to have a reception after the concert. So if you'll please join us over in the Trishman Gallery after the concert, that'll be a great opportunity for you to meet everyone, meet everybody in the wind ensemble, our guest soloists, guest performers. So it'll be a good time. Please come over to Trishman Gallery after the concert is over. So we will now close with perhaps the best concert ender that has ever been written. Ottorino Respighi's last movement of his famous work, The Pines of Rome, will be playing this last movement, which is titled Pines of the Appian Way. In the piece, The Pines of Rome, Respighi has four different movements, and in each movement, he's trying to depict not just a tree, but rather the atmosphere surrounding these particular pines in various locations in Rome. And Pines of the Appian Way depicts this victorious Roman army returning to the city of Rome via this very famous thoroughfare known as the Appian Way. So these trees are watching over this procession, this slow but proud procession. And mixed in with this very slow march, you're going to hear the very subtle but lamenting cries of all the captives that the Roman army is bringing back with them as they return to Rome. For this performance, I want to make sure to thank some special guest performers who are joining us in the trumpet section. You will find their names listed under the trumpet section of the personnel, but I just wanted to make sure to give them special thanks. They are students over at the University of Central Arkansas, and we're very thankful to have them here to add some more power to our brass section for this incredible last piece. So we hope you will enjoy, to close the program, Respighi's The Pines of the Appian Way.